This is Yasser from Dublin City University. My work is mostly about unsupervised methods for learning on graphs. So representation learning on graphs raises many conceptual and technical challenges in contrast to images where learning algorithms benefit from this implicit abstract relation between objects. For example, in these scenes, you can easily recognize the objects and how they relate to each other in a hierarchical and organized way. Whereas for networks, the equivalent conclusions aren't valid anymore. I mean, a standard deep learning toolbox don't really work for this non-Euclidean data distributions. For this, we have what you call graph neural networks. The way I see them is having a model where the main idea is to pass messages along edges of the graph. And these messages are basically parameterized by some neural network. Then we decode the node representation according to the problem at hand. However, like getting graph labeled well annotated data is costly in many cases, even intractable in some cases. So learning good quality representations without any supervised signal is highly valuable for the downstream tasks in the context of graphs. For doing so, most recent approaches follow this contrastive learning framework, which is some kind of mutual information maximization. So we have a graph, some kind of graph. Then we get the latent representations using any GNN architecture. Then we embed the representations in a space. And finally, we have to score like pairs in this space. They should be positive if they are connected in the input graph, or negative if they are not connected in the input graph. And this has to be done through a sampling strategy to draw the negative samples and an augmentation module to decide the positive sample. And usually for the loss function, we use this family of noise contrastive estimation or infogan. My research focuses on improving and designing better choices for the different components of this contrastive framework with an application to routing problems, namely TSP and VRP. Why this is important? So despite the fact that no labeled data is needed for the learning process, this also would help to meet the design paradigm for representation learning. I mean, satisfying this notion of feature reuse across different tasks for graph type data, which basically explains the power of distributed representations that is also at the heart of conceptual advantages of deep learning.